All right, Coach, so you were very open and blunt in your assessment on what happened Saturday. How do you, with acknowledging what happened on Saturday, how do you move forward this week and just say, hey, we recognize we didn't meet what we were trying to do, but we got another opportunity come Saturday?
Well, one of the main pillars of our program is accountability. So when we don't perform to the levels that we need to perform at, we got to be accountable for it. And we need to be able to take a look in the mirror, see what we did right or wrong, and be able to work hard at fixing it. I think our biggest failure on Saturday was purely effort. I think our effort started to wane, and we really tailed off at the end. There was some good fight early, but it left us pretty quick, and that's the biggest thing that we need to make sure that we get back to, is that we can give great effort for 60 minutes.
What do you look at matchup-wise offensively when you look at what UMary's done in the last four games? How do you, do they present challenges from a defensive standpoint?
Well, UMary presents challenges because they're the only ones that do what they do, and so you have to... For us, as we're trying to progress every week and trying to get better at our base defense and learn from our mistakes, all that really kind of goes out the window this week because of the different style of offense that they run. We have to be much more specialized, I guess, would be the best way to put it, to be able to defend how they play with the triple option and those type of things. So we kind of have to put some of those things on hold that we've got to keep getting better at in our base defense. But, when it comes into this week, where we failed, which was effort, that's what we got to make sure that we get back to and doing the little things right. And, one of the other things we got caught into doing too much was trying to do other people's jobs and overcompensating for somebody if they made a mistake and putting ourselves out of position. And when you play a triple option team, assignment football is the most important thing that you can do. So that's really our focus this week.
How did the guys react yesterday when you broke down the film and then went over the different stuff that they may have waned on effort there?
I think probably the two biggest adjectives would be disappointment and embarrassment in themselves. They know that they can play a lot better, and we hadn't shown that quit, in the first three games. But those first three games were still manageable scores all the way to the end. And I think once the score started to get out of hand a little bit, some of that old doubt starts to creep in, and it's, you start feeling sorry for yourself, and once you start feeling sorry for yourself, you start getting put on the ground. So, like I said, for us, the whole focus is just, can we play at a high level, play with great tempo, and know that there's going to be mistakes. How quickly can we rebound from them, and how quickly can we manage them?
Any update on Zach's shoulder and who is going to start?
No update. This is our off day, so we're definitely using that to our advantage. See what our medical staff has to say when we get back at the end of the day here. And then as we get ready for practice Tuesday, we'll have a better idea of who's going to take reps with the first team. If he's 100% healthy, it'll probably be Zach. But Andy also proved that he can do some things for us too. So it gives us some definite things to think about and look at.
How did you like Andy's performance coming in that situation? Did he handle it pretty well?
I think he did. I think he probably put a little too much pressure on himself. Which is obvious. You're a guy that was competing for that starting job and disappointed that you didn't get it. And when you get that first opportunity to get out there, you want to really, be able to show everybody that you do deserve that job, which is 100% understandable. And so sometimes you force things a little too much. And I think he did a great job keeping some plays alive. He made some good throws. He made some decisions that we don't want him to make. He also gave us a little bit of a spark too that we needed. So I thought that he did a good job coming in off the bench. He had a great week. He had the best week that he's had with us. I thought that he was rewarded justly for that. So we'll see how this week goes.
I know you were trying to teach the guys this week about just having the effort for 60 minutes, but with the matchup that you have this weekend, isn't that sort of easy to get up for? It's your first division game, rivalry game, on the road. There's no way that they wouldn't have that kind of effort that you're looking for just based on this matchup this weekend, right?
Right. Well, I mean, that's what you hope for. I mean, but I've been coaching long enough to where you assume that a team is up and ready to go for a game, and then you walk out and they're not, which is what happened to us on Saturday. And I know there's a lot of those little side notes of divisional game and in-state game and all those other things, but we can't take any of it for granted. I mean, we got to make sure that that we push them hard as coaches to make sure that they are up for not just the game, but all week of practice, so we don't just go through any of the motions. And I purely believe you win the game in practice, and the game is just kind of the icing on the cake, and we didn't win the game in practice last week for sure. So we've got to do a better job coaching to be able to push them and understand the importance of what we're doing and how we play and things like that. So I hope they're going to be up for the game, but I don't want to put hope in my hand and watch my hand open up and do nothing there. So we just got to push them and create that